'cause I'm the MVP. I'm stupid with this rap shit.
I'm the man. Why isn't this a national holiday? United States of America. Get with the program. I'm the man.
Welcome to the Robbie V Show. When Premier puts the needle on the record, then I put it on blast. It blows garbage, I throw it in the trash. I'm the MVP. We're going to do things a little differently here, folks. The first thing we're going to do, we're going to get right to what you want. And that's the lock for the week. Speakers popping on a handstand. They sneak dissing niggas throwing little jabs like Bam Bam. But I'm a bad man. They amateurs like at Apollo. I wipe them off the stage like Sandman. Damn, man. What the hell you smoking on? It's ludicrous. I got more cheese than provolone. And the chrome is...
Well, welcome to the Robbie V Show. It's going to be a big week this week, so let's get right to it. First off, the lock of the week. It went 2-1 last week. Good old, I think it was Nevada and UC, University of Central Florida. They both won for the victories, and then fucking Creighton, they lost. So that wasn't too good, obviously. I hope this sounds better because I got a new microphone. Like, shocking breaking news development here. Robbie V has a new microphone. I hope the people love it. a lot is going on, obviously. Let me just get the golf picks up. Should have had this done earlier, but, you know, what are you going to do? Yeah. Where are they? God damn it. Well, hopefully we have a better middle and a better end to the show. But, you know, let's see. All right, there we go. So, Hootie's been on fire lately with his soccer picks and his golf picks. If you want his soccer picks, we can obviously have him post the, you know, his own account. And, you know, Boomer Haveron is, into the show account. But yeah, he's been on fire. He did good with the golf picks last week. This weekend is the PGA Tours. They're at the TAGC Constant Classic. I think that's a new tournament because I've never heard of this thing before. But let's kind of get to him. All right, so Chris Kirk right now is one of his picks. He's a plus 210 for top 20. BHM, he's plus 330 for a top 10. I'm going to bang this up, but we're going to go for it anyway. Rasmus Højgaard or something. I'll spell it out so you can just look it up on DraftKings. Højgaard is plus 140 for the top, for top 30. This is the play of the week according to Hootie. This is going to hit, so you better get your money down quick, you know. It's all over at Robbie V Loves It, and it's all over the Robbie V Show, as well as Hootie's Boomer and Haveron Twitter account. So, can't say you didn't see it before Thursday. CJ Pond is currently plus 140 for a top 40, and Sepp Straka over a Blue Holster head to head for the tourney is on minus 110. So, for his pizza money picks, these are basically a winner. Or top 10, or top 5, or top 10 long shots are Cole, Mitchell Haws, and Erik van Rysen. Erik van Rysen actually had a decent two rounds last week because I was following him. And, you know, he played well, so he might be worth a shot on a couple of those. Locally, what's going on is, what can you say, you know? BC's starting to get the offers out. You know, they offer a tight end out of Alabama. They're getting a lot of official visits. Billy O'Brien is doing a great job so far. And even though he's only been a coach for about 2 weeks, but his staff is rounding out. You really can't complain. And, they're doing well. The Bruins have hit sort of a skid lately, which, you know, obviously isn't that good. They played a lot of overtime games, and unfortunately, they're losing a lot of them. You know, latest was the Kraken. They're playing Vegas right now. You know, by the time you see this, the game's going to be over, so it's really no point in looking at it. We're 2 weeks away from March Madness. I have to admit, you know, obviously the top three teams in the nation are Houston, UConn, and Purdue. I mean, they all play great defense. UConn, You know, Houston had a big win the other night. UConn got back on track beating Villanova. It's going to be a great tournament. And basically the night before, just want to announce now, the night before the first round games, or the Thursday first round games, Wednesday night, we're going to have hopefully a live show on the network to talk the NCAAs. If you want to get involved, just let me know. But, you know, obviously, well, I mean, the more the merrier, but we can't have like 50 people on, but, you know, we already have some people lined up, so it's going to be a good time. I want you guys to watch it. The one thing, you know, Rugby show took some criticism, you know. We're going to get back to what got us here in the first place. You know, it certainly wasn't gambling. It was, you know, the wonk, the MVPs, the dope of the days, and the wonk of the week. So I took a very special care of those this week, and I want to get through those now. All right. So the MVPs is like Lock and Riley. She's obviously our MVP. Unfortunately, on a sad note, like, unfortunately, you know, she was brutally murdered by an illegal immigrant from, I believe, Venezuela, down in Athens, Georgia, and University of Georgia. She showed incredible bravery. She fought back, and for everything that's coming out in the media, and she was a great nursing student, and yeah, it's a tragedy what happened to her. Could have been avoided, obviously. And, you know, she's our MVP. Obviously, heart goes out to her friends, her family, in the Georgia community. I know we have some Mets fans down there. It's probably an issue close to their hearts. So, Lockin's our MVP for, you know, probably for a little while. You know, the other who's not MVP is, the first dope of the day is Athens, Georgia Mayor. You know, yeah, he ran this press conference. He, you know, so stuff, and, you know, so illegal immigration didn't cause the murder. Yeah, it's an interesting way to think, because it had everything to do with it. Hot takes like that just don't. They definitely earned the dope of the day. It's not a good call. It's not funny. But let's talk about Fannie Wells. And she's another dope of the day. Why is she dope of the day? Well, first of all, I mean, she wore a dress backwards on the fucking witness stand a week ago. I mean, let's think about that. I mean, I'm Robbie V. I somehow managed to put my clothes on right side, the right way, and get out every morning, even, you know, taking my daughter to daycare. Fannie Wells had like 8 hours to put her dress on right. Instead, she just, well, she put it on backwards. That's not good. You know, I question what's going on with her. And I also question, like, if she could be more out of the month. I mean, when Robbie V is questioning your dressing acumen, coming from, like, the least fashionable person probably ever, considering my, you know, wardrobe consists of pullovers, blue shirts, and blue jeans, which probably have a salsa stain on from the night before. Yeah, it's not good. Fannie Wells needs to look inside and see what's there. All right. We're going to move on to another. We're going to move on to Wonk of the Week. Who, you know, he's definitely not a first-time Wonk of the Week. You know, this gentleman, he could be a lifetime wonk for all we know. It's just, it's not good. So who am I talking about? You know, I'm talking about good old Miami Dolphins, Tyreek Hill, who really is just a fucking jerk. Tyreek Hill, you know, according to The Guardian, he's been sued by a plus size influencer with more than 2 million followers who claimed her leg was broken at the football star's mansion last year during a backyard football lesson gone wrong. Now, let's just kind of, like, take that here. How does a backyard football lesson go wrong? I mean, you're probably just playing catch. I mean, I don't think Tyreek is throwing a block in his life, so I don't think he's teaching blocking. Makes you wonder, like, what in God's name is Tyreek Hill doing with his life? You know, I know he's making $30 million a year, but he's kind of a dope. All right. So Sophie Hall is this influencer. She's a modeling actor who lives in Pascal County. She claims she was invited to take part in the offensive line blocking drill after watching Hill train in his backyard. Hill claims she was asked to visit Hill's home after registering her son to the to his football camp, and she sent some direct messages, and yeah. So basically, this lawsuit alleges that, yeah, in the first rep, Hill, who's 6'1", alleges she managed to push the 5'10 Hill backward, drawing a rafter from a group of witnesses, and they included his trainer, mother, and sister. And then, unfortunately, the roles reversed, and Hill set up the same drill with the roles reversed, and yeah, I mean, he charged into her violently with great force, resulting in significant and serious injuries. Hall suffered a fractured right leg, and which required surgery and motor hardware implementation. I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer, but I don't really think Tyreek Hill's got a lot going on upstairs, especially after, violently laying out a plus-size model in his backyard. And I don't really think it speaks well of his family either to be laughing at that. It's really not that funny. He's well-deserving of the lock of the week. It's probably going to be moron of the month. And, that's about it. So what else we got going on? So, because we always have stuff going on in the Robbie V show. So, obviously, another MVP today is obviously Tim Wakefield's wife, Stacy, who tragically died from cancer. The Wakefields, they actually used to live, I believe they used to live in Black Rock and Hingham. They're great people. They did a lot of charity work. They have a great reputation around town. Tim was always going to be an MVP, and Stacy as well. It's tragic. Cancer sucks, and that's it. It's one of those where it's very sad. It's very sad. Who's dope of the day is Red Sox prospect Brainer Bianchi, suspended for the 2024 season. At least it's reported. I don't know. He's basically violated the minor leagues, domestic violence, sexual assault, and child abuse policy. Yeah, so this guy definitely is more out of the month. I mean, this guy needs to freaking get it together. Obey the law. Do the basic things that somehow I'm able to do every day. It's an absolute fucking joke. Rob V., I don't stand for that fucking tomfoolery. The Celtics tonight. They're not playing tonight, but I hope the Celtics keep it up. They've been playing well lately with a nice beat down of Philly, even though it took them a while to get going. But hey, what are you gonna do? Obviously the Sixers right now are struggling without Embiid. Doesn't really have to. Doesn't take a rocket science to figure out that. Also, the Celtics right now are +110 for Eastern Conference champion. It's interesting because really, the only team really going to be in their way is probably Milwaukee. And maybe the Knicks. But who knows? There's always some emerging. Somebody emerges. But it's last but not least, the final dope of the day award of the Robbie V Show goes to Andrew Augustus, who showed up to the Kirkman Manhattan recording. Smelling a weed. I mean, be better, Andrew. I don't know. I wouldn't go to my former place of employment reeking a boat or booze or pot or whatever. Andrew Augustus has got I think he's got a job now. But you just got to think about these things, Andrew. But I know you'll pull through. I know you're going to pull it out. All right. So what's going on for the, what's the lock of the week schedule? Why is Robbie V wearing, freaking another pullover? All right, this is the lock of the week schedule. So on Friday, it's going to come out by 5 o'clock. It'll be, either from my car or whatever. You have the, I don't know if it's going to be college basketball or what. We'll have the lock of the week. Saturday, hopefully, I'll have the pick out by 11. It's been tough to do videos with the daughter, so. What are you going to do? I'll look, you know, I'll try to get it up. And Sunday, we'll see how Friday and Saturday goes before we take a look at Sunday's lock of the week. Okay. Now, last but not least, I want you to watch, obviously, the main show, Kirk Minahan. I want you to watch Mike of the Minifans on the Kirk Minahan Network. And I also want you to be on the lookout for the Jeopardy show that's coming up with Beanbag Ron and McFustaddy. They're putting in a lot of time and hard work, and it's definitely programming that, you know, it's going to be a good ride. No doubt about it. All right, so that's really it. I hope you enjoyed the show tonight. And again, take care of yourself and each other. And, you know, and finally, the Robbie V Show is brought to you by, you know, Born and Bred Food Truck. You know, the Chicken 65 sandwich, you can't miss it. It's the best sandwich ever, other than a Pervetti sub. But, you know, I love the Chicken 65 sandwich. So this is Robbie V signing off. Thank you.